Thank you. everyone. We are expecting a full house, so if we can ensure that there's no empty seats, just snuggle into your neighbors. Please don't leave any empty seats so that we can fit everybody in. No one has to stand. There's a few seats left on the floor, but let's just get cozy and make sure everyone has a seat. Thank you. Hi, everyone. We're just about ready to get started. Once again, we do ask, if you're not saving seats and we're getting to that point where it's about time to stop, please move in to your neighbors so we can get everybody in. There's some extra seats. We can cozy up to our neighbors. We've got lots of people that are standing. We'd love to be able to give them a seat. It's going to be a bit of a long ceremony, and get everybody seated, that'd be great. So once again, we ask that you please move over and fill all those empty seats, and let's try and get some of those single ones together so people can sit. Thank you. Starting in just a moment. Good evening. As we open the graduation ceremonies of 2019, I ask that you please stand for our processional. After all of our special guests, graduates, have entered, please remain standing for our land acknowledgement and the playing of O Canada.
Good evening. Part of the reconciliation process with Canada's Indigenous people is to recognize that they were the first people to inhabit this land. Simcoe County District School Board acknowledges that we are situated on the traditional land of the Anishinaabeg people. The Anishinaabeg include the Ojibwe, the Odawa, the Bodwadame nations, collectively known as the Three Fires Confederacy. We are dedicated to honoring Indigenous history and culture and committed to moving forward in the spirit of reconciliation and respect with all First Nation, Métis, and Inuit people. Please remain standing and remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you. You may be seated. Good evening. My name is Rob Howitson, and I, along with my colleague, Dana Wright, will be serving as the MCs for tonight's ceremonies. We'd like to extend a warm welcome to our distinguished guests, families, teachers, administrators, and most importantly, the graduates of 2019. Now, before I hand the mic over to my colleague, I want to make everyone aware the bathrooms are out in the hallway, back the way you came in. Please be aware that the lighting is quite dim up in the stands. We do have ushers with flashlights strategically stationed in the aisles to assist you should you require. Again, we'd like to optimize our seating and ensure no one is left standing. And so we ask that if you have any empty seats between you and your neighbor, please get cozy. Now, I will turn the mic over to my colleague, Dana Wright, to address this year's graduating class on behalf of the Banting staff.
I think we need to rent the Rogers Center the next time. Mr. Bernardi, our graduates have a lot of fans. It's my pleasure to serve as the co-MC for the graduating class of 2019. I've assumed this role for well over a decade, and I swear every year is going to be my last, but I always get super excited to provide opening remarks to a particular group, and this crew is no exception. As your teachers, we've had the privilege of sharing your high school journey with you. This opportunity has afforded us a unique perspective into your individual challenges and successes. Navigating the teenage years is a daunting task. You spent the past 4 years becoming better jugglers. You're forced to manage your own expectations of yourself, as well as those of your peers, your teachers, your coaches, your staff advisors, your administrators, your first employers, and of course, your parents and guardians. And although we are supposed to be the adults in your lives, you have sometimes had to remind us, not always so gently, that some of these expectations that we place on you are not always fair, realistic, or respectful of the people that you want to become. Sometimes you have dropped the balls as you navigate the juggling act, and I truly hope that as a school community, we've been able to help you pick them back up again. The fact that you're seated in those chairs tonight indicates that you've succeeded in the teenage scene, and you're now ready to move to the next big stage, the adult play. One of the best things about our jobs as educators is that we've had front row seats to watch you mature and develop your own sense of self and sense of purpose. This is a graduating class that has consistently demonstrated caring and respect for each other. The initiatives taken by this group to address mental health, anti-racism, anti-bullying, and general wellness, led by you, the students, for your fellow students, are a testament to your commitment to be sensitive, active citizens of a changing world. You seem to genuinely like each other. You both accept and celebrate diversity, and in so doing, you serve as role models and teachers to us, to the generations of students that preceded you, and to those who will follow. So as you walk across this stage tonight, please understand that each and every one of you is a star of this performance. Congratulations, graduates of 2019.
At this time, I'd like to make some introductions. We'll start first with Banting's administration. Starting closest to me, in the center of the stage, our principal, Alberto Bernardi. Vice principal, Allison Chernabai. Vice principal, Marcel Wolf. And finally, on the far end of the stage, vice principal, Brent Millsap. We also have with us a number of community dignitaries representing local donors who continue to support Banting in an integral way, both through their presence here tonight and through their generosity. They will be introduced individually as they hand out specific awards to student recipients. Before we get started with the official part of the ceremony, I would also like to thank the town of New Tecumseh and the staff here at the Recreation Center for working hard to support this event and helping turn this hockey arena into our commencement stage. Deputy Mayor Richard Norcross is here this evening to represent the town. I ask that he please stand and allow graduates and their families to acknowledge all that the town has done for them. Thank you. I would now like to ask Banting's principal, Mr. Bernardi, to come to the podium to welcome you and address the graduates.
Good evening. This is absolutely fantastic to see this place bursting at the seams, and the Rogers Center might be something to consider for next year. Just want to really thank everybody for coming out to this very important ceremony. I would be lying to all of you if I didn't tell you that this was a little bit more special this year, this commencement ceremony for me, for a number of reasons, but this is the class of 2019 or 2001 babies, and I've seen many of you grow up into such great young citizens. For some of you, we first met when you were 3 years old playing on a soccer field. For some of you, on your first day of junior kindergarten. For some of you, at McDonald's or Tim Hortons drive-through or the cash registers at Zehrs or Canadian Tire. And for many, at the hockey rink where we have had and created many great memories. In the short time that I've had with you as your principal, we were able to continue in creating these great memories that will definitely stay with me a lifetime. I cannot emphasize enough how proud I am of all of you, and to stand here today as your principal is a huge honor. I know that you will all find your place in this world and that you will do great things as you move forward with your life. You are marauders tonight, and you will always be a marauder. Enjoy the evening, be proud, for you have a lot of reason to be. Congratulations to all of you.
Thank you, Mr. Bernardi. I would now like to invite our local trustee, Sarah Weitz, to the podium to deliver her remarks.
Hello, welcome. There's a lot of people here tonight. All right, so as said, I am your trustee, Sarah Weitz, and I'm here to celebrate your accomplishments and leave you some parting words of wisdom on behalf of Chair Lloyd and all of the other trustees at the Simcoe County District School Board. Today marks a milestone along your life's journey. You have worked hard, persevered, and met all the requirements necessary to graduate. Remember all those little steps that got you here? From your first steps into kindergarten to those many, many awkward shuffles in between, and finally, to the long strides that have landed you here today, despite your personal route full of many ups and downs, always remember that you made it here today.
When I left home to pursue post-secondary studies at McMaster University, I failed my first test horribly in a course that I had done very well at in high school. I was shocked and devastated. I had never failed a test before. I walked around aimlessly for the next hour. I didn't know what to do. I was shaken to the core, and I started to doubt everything. And then I remembered some words my mother told me many, many times in my life. Whenever I was struggling with something, I remember she used to come up to me, put her hand on me, on my back, and say, "You can figure it out." And so I did. I realized it was just a test, and I went on to complete that course and graduate. When you start to doubt yourself, and you all will at some point, stop. Stop doubting yourself and start doubting your doubts. I'm going to say that again because it's a bit of a tongue twister. Stop doubting yourself and start doubting your doubts. If you were smart enough to be admitted to a program, then you are smart enough to complete that same program. Whether you do so or not is completely up to you. No one will take attendance, make sure you do your work, or even wake you up in the morning. It's all up to you, and you can do it. When you experience a failure or get discouraged, don't let it defeat you. Get back up and try again. You have not failed until you quit. Now, I want to be 100% practical with you for a minute, so you'll have to excuse me. The desired outcome of any post-secondary education or training is to end up well-employed with as little debt as possible. Some debt may be necessary as you embark upon the next phase of your life. However, do not let riotous living now leave you with crippling debt that could rob your future. If you have yet to consider a career in the skilled trades, and the stats in the province indicate that way more than half of you haven't graduating here today, the fact is that the skilled trade shortage in Ontario is very real, urgent, and expected to last for decades to come. Those who pursue the trades will likely find themselves upon completion well-employed with savings instead of debts. Now, we're going to dream for a minute. Close your eyes. I want you to envision your life 10 to 15 years from now. What does it look like? Where do you work? Do you own your own business? Where do you live? Do you own a home? Are you married? What about kids? Etc., etc. Take some time to record your vision of your future and then review it and add to it often. In the next several years, you will make many big life decisions that will form the rest of your life. When presented with one of these decisions, keep your vision in front of you. Study it out, consider all the ramifications, and then talk it over with the oldest, wisest person you know to get perspective, like a grandparent. Once your head and your heart agree, go forward with hope and confidence. Finally, throughout your time with us at the Simcoe County District School Board, we have been endeavoring to teach you to be good people. Through our various character education efforts, starting in kindergarten all the way through grade 12. Regardless of the path you pursue, remember to always be caring, cooperative, courageous, empathetic, inclusive, optimistic, respectful, responsible, and to live each day with integrity. Your future career and training are important, but they are not what is most important. As you start this exciting next chapter, always remember to make time for what matters most. Thank you for allowing me to speak tonight. It's been a great honor. And congratulations to the class of 2019.
Thank you, Ms. Bites. And finally, I'd like to invite the superintendent and associate director, John Dance, to the podium to bring greetings from the Simcoe County District School Board.
I'm very pleased to speak to you tonight on behalf of the senior administrative team of the Simcoe County District School Board. I have the honor of sharing greetings from our Director of Education, Steve Blake, and regrets from my colleague Superintendent Darrell Halliday that he cannot be here tonight. Graduates, congratulations. You're now graduates of a great institution in Banting Memorial. You've achieved a goal for yourself that will open doors and provide you with choices and opportunities to make your own path into the future. You've attained a goal that marks a change in your life from one of young adult and student to that of a real adult. This accomplishment is no small task. You should be very proud of yourselves. At celebrations such as this, we see how true our board's mission statement is. We inspire and empower learning for life. Whatever pathway you choose from here, we hope that this has set you on that path. Mr. Bernardi had mentioned that you are the true millennials, born in 2001, graduating in 2019. Please try to remember your parents and the other people of importance in your life. Take a minute to thank them for their support, their guidance, and their encouragement. A hug, a handshake, or maybe even a kiss to remind your parents of the path to today's celebration. You're fortunate to come from a school such as Banting Memorial. We truly appreciate the work of the staff, the administrative team, and this community as it expects excellence from you, and you've provided that excellence back with demonstrating character in your many efforts. We know that you'll take with you as you move on to the next stage in your life great memories of your years at Banting Memorial. Enjoy the ceremony and also our congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Dance. It's now time in the program to honor the recipients of our prestigious Morrow Banting Award. This award is presented to two graduating students earning their OSSD who have consistently demonstrated scholarship, integrity, and leadership in one or more intramural or interschool activities. I'd ask that this year's recipients, Isha Mahmood and Ben Posetti, please join us up here on stage. Okay, guys. You're going to be up here for a little bit, and you're going to listen carefully to my instructions. We're going to invite two speakers up, one at a time, to speak to each of our Morrow Banting recipients. The first speaker, Mr. Bernardi, is going to speak to Isha. So I'd ask that Ben just step back a bit, and I'd invite Mr. Bernardi to the podium.
Hello, Isha. So here we are. Many of you may think that Isha and I only know each other for the last three semesters. This is not true, right? We actually know each other for about 2 years. You see, when I was a principal at another school, some kid wrote me a letter telling me that she didn't want to come to my school. I said, are you kidding? You're not coming to my school? So she wrote me the following. This is good. So she said, my name is Isha Mahmood, and I am currently a grade 10 student at Banting Memorial High School. I started at Banting in September 2015 after moving from Milton. Moving to a new town right before grade 9 was very difficult as I was going into high school without knowing anyone. Banting provided me with such a warm welcome and I quickly made many friends and got myself involved within the school. I am a very involved member in my school community. I am an active member on student council and will be running for vice president at the end of the year. And then she became president for these last 2 years. That's right, you can cheer. And I'm also part of the Athletic Society, the mock UN debate team, which I think you guys won again this year. That's right, you can cheer, it's okay. And up until 2016, I was a youth leader for Health Canada's STACK project. Currently, and still was this year, the president of Banting's and Simcoe County District School Board's first ever Jack.org mental wellness chapter. I have established a commitment to Banting's wide variety of extracurriculars and programs, as well as the surrounding community. I am a well-rounded student and have a dedication to leadership and student improvement, which is why I would like to stay at Banting. She also went on, she's such a well-rounded student and dedicated leader, she won the Lauren Scholarship Award, which I believe only goes out to 25 students across Canada. I have a passion for bettering my school community and will continue to do so
to the best of my ability. Banting has all the resources and extracurriculars that lead to my dedication and commitment to the school community, as well as offering the courses that will take me to my future destination. Hope to continue the rest of my high school career here at Banting for my own betterment. Well, that's okay, Isha, because if you're not going to come to me, I will find you and I will come to you. So here I am. It is truly amazing how this young woman accomplished everything and more that she stated in her letter 2-3 years ago in great time. You mentioned that Banting would make you a better person, but Isha, the truth is that you and your commitment to this community has made Banting an extremely better place. And for that, a huge thank you. Congratulations, Isha Mahmood.
Thank you, Mr. Bernardi. Okay, we'll let Isha off the spotlight for a minute. And now it's Ben's turn, and I'm going to invite Ms. Lauren Olson from our drama department to the stage.
Hello! So I was told I only had 2 minutes to talk about Ben, so let's get started. No, that's not it. Oh. Take a few minutes to acknowledge the fantastic contributions and scholarship of Ben Cassetti. On Ben's kindergarten report card, his teacher wrote, "Benjamin confidently demonstrates independence, self-regulation, and a willingness to take responsibility in learning. He always demonstrates self-motivation, initiative, and confidence by selecting and completing learning tasks." I have had the privilege of teaching Ben the last 4 years. I couldn't agree more with what his kindergarten teacher said. I knew when I met Ben, he was a worthy candidate for the Banting Morrow Award. When he came into my classroom as little 14-year-old Ben, he was confident, respectful, a team player, listened well, smart as a whip, and good at everything. During his time with us at Banting, he has made me laugh more times than I can count. He has been a link crew leader, part of the Delft French Club, Glee Club, Senior Band, part of the French Immersion Program, and has performed in many of our school activities, including Fine Arts Night, talent shows, coffee houses, Night of Excellence, and the Remembrance Day assemblies. He has been involved in all these activities while maintaining a 95% and above average throughout all 4 years of high school. He has also been very involved in extracurricular activities. He recently composed the musical score to a show called Passing Tones that we brought to the NTS Theater Festival. The show won and continued to the regional level. At the district level, he won an award of excellence for top male lead performer and won an award of merit for original score. He has been on the football team for 3 years and is coached for 2. Mr. Haas said he is a feared tackler and has perfect technique in football. He is one of the best players Banting has ever had. Outside of school, he teaches piano, tutors math, writes and records songs, helps out at a local potato festival, Matthew's Hospice, Relay for Life, and hockey games. He is a valued member of our community. Next year, he will be going to McGill to study music, which is his passion. Mr. Healy would like to note that Ben is a consummate musician. Ben recently learned the trombone in 4 months, a task that usually takes students 4 years to accomplish. Before closing, I would also like to acknowledge Ben's parents. Job well done. I want to talk to you later about how I get my sons to turn out like that. I would like to leave you now with a quote from a song that Ben wrote. "Look up, rise and fall. Life carries on, the world doesn't stall. Look up, see a sky with a million lights. Look up, watch the birds in daring flight. Look up and see that you aren't alone. Though souls may part, they never let go." Good luck, Ben. We'll miss you.
Okay, as soon as There we go. Okay, so now let's test the intelligence of our two Morrow Banting recipients. You have to listen to my instructions very carefully. We are going to award each with a plaque. So I'd like to invite Isha and Mr. Bernardi back to the stage for Isha to receive her plaque. And to present Ben with his plaque, I'd like to invite Mr. Larry Keough, the principal that actually hired me. Tells you how old we both are. From the Nottawasaga Foundation. Okay, now the whole gang has to stay. Don't walk off the stage, good, okay. And you're gonna hold up that big honking plaque for the photographer. The two recipients are the closest. Yeah, you got to put your little plaques down. You're doing the big honking plaque. Oh, might have been a mistake, these guys. But anyways, yeah, okay, good. There we go, perfect. This year's Morrow Banting recipients. Okay, congratulations. Okay, at this time we'd like to recognize this year's Ontario Scholars. Grads, you've already received your medals, indicating that you've obtained an average above 80%. Congratulations on this significant achievement, and I'd ask that you'd stand so that you can be recognized by the audience as well. Big hand to our Ontario Scholars.
Thank you. Okay, it's time for the highlight of the evening, presentation of your diplomas. Yes. I'd like to remind graduates that if you have a star sticker on your card, that indicates you are also receiving an award. That means you need to stay on the stage after you get your diploma in order to receive that additional award. As the students begin to take their places, I would like to note that in an effort to keep our ceremonies moving along as quickly as possible, unfortunately, parents will not be able to take individual photos of grads during the ceremony. But since we could not facilitate you taking photographs, we have secured for us a professional photographer who will take a photo of each grad as they cross the stage. One of these photos will be provided to each family free of charge and will be available for pickup in the school in the first week of July. If you're interested in purchasing, if you're interested in purchasing additional photos, there are instructions in your program as to how you can place an order. I would also like to take this opportunity to acknowledge and thank the very many people who have worked hard to make this evening possible. It has taken the collective effort of our secretaries, our administration, the commencement committee, and an amazing staff who have stepped up to ensure that this evening happens in what have been some very tight timelines. I would also like to thank our student link crew volunteers for giving up their evening to contribute to the commencement process. And before you know it, you folks will be sitting here in these seats for hours. I'd also like to acknowledge our custodial staff, our educational assistants, who can never receive enough recognition and play an integral role behind the scenes, not just in commencement, but are also critical members of the larger team that keeps our old, wonderful high school running smoothly. So thank you to the members of our Banting team for your hard work in making this evening possible. Our local community also contributes to this evening in many ways. From those like Burns Flowers, who have donated the flowers for this evening, to many who have generously contributed to the awards we are presenting tonight. We are reminded that Banting is a community high school by the fact that the financial and other supports we have received once again have exceeded our expectations. Thank you to all our award sponsors, both businesses and individuals, for their efforts in honoring our graduates. So, please join me in recognizing all of those people who have contributed to making this evening a wonderful success.
Okay, I believe that we're just about ready to start the diploma process. I would like to, before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge the voices behind the wall introducing our graduates. Tonight, those voices are of Richard Pearson and Aaron Cushman, both teachers in our English department. Quick few reminders about protocol. To our grads, while we appreciate that you're excited for your friends to walk across the stage, we encourage you to show that excitement through applause instead of shouting out. Also, after you've received your diploma, please return to your seat. And finally, a respectful reminder to both our grads and our audience to please stay seated for the duration of the ceremony. I know it's really hot, but as a lady that's a W, you have to remember that as we get to the end of the alphabet, we need to have some people watching those folks graduating as well. Okay, our first set of diplomas will be given out by our principal, Mr. Alberto Bernardi.
Juliana Abbas. Juliana will be attending University of Ontario Institute of Technology for Health Science.
Aleem Abdullah. Aleem will be attending Georgian York Nursing Collaboration.
Aleem is also the recipient. Oh, stay, Aleem. Stay. Of a Helen and John Ray bursary to a deserving student who's attending a post-secondary program, Ms. Chornabai, if you would come up and present this, please.
Rachel Abungan. Rachel will be attending George Brown College in Toronto to study early childhood education.
Taylor Albano. Taylor will be attending the University of Toronto for History and Political Science.
Benjamin Aylman. Benjamin will be attending York University for Physics.
Ben is also the recipient of the Mackenzie Beattie Memorial Award. I'd like to ask Mike Wright of our science department to come up and present Ben the award for achieving the highest mark in grade 12 university physics.
McKenna and Sarah. McKenna will be attending Sheridan for Honors Bachelor of Interior Design.
McKenna is also the recipient of the Vahili Gastaldi Barristers and Solicitors Award. I'd like to ask Mr. Paul Andres of our Canada World Studies Department to present this award to McKenna for the highest mark in grade 12 college legal studies. McKenna is also receiving a Helen and John Ray bursary being presented by Ms. Allison Chornabai to a deserving student who's attending a post-secondary program. And McKenna is also receiving the Tetra Ninja Productions Award from Mr. Kevin Reynolds of our Guidance Department to a student who's demonstrated significant courage in facing personal challenge.
Megan and Sarah. Megan will be attending Centennial College for Social Service Work.
Cassandra Armstrong. Cassandra will be attending Laurentian University for a concurrent education with sport and physical education.
John Atkinson. John will be enjoying his time away from Banting.
Destiny Atias. Destiny will be going to Aurelia Georgian College for Police Foundations.
Samantha O'Coin. Samantha will be attending Laurentian University for a Bachelor of Fine Arts.
S- Samantha is also the recipient of the Don McLean Memorial Award, being presented by Mr. Matt Healy of our music department for the highest mark in grade 12 university music.
Kate Oxtokolis. Kate will be taking a year off and then going to college for dental hygiene.
Daniel Austin. Daniel will be attending Dalhousie University to study marine biology.
Julia Abramidas. Julia will be attending Western University for social sciences criminology major.
Brandon Gonzalez. Brandon will be attending class for the summer.
Brianna Maybe. Brianna will be attending camp and spending time with family.
Mark Nichols. Mark will be attending the Passages program and looking for volunteer work.
Haley Kuzmanis. Haley will be taking a year off and then deciding.
Larissa McDermott. Larissa plans to work with children in a daycare or as a teacher.
Wyatt Prothero. Wyatt will be playing video games and having fun.
Danish Ayom. Danish will be attending Seneca College for paralegal.
Elizabeth Ballandue will be attending University of Waterloo for life science.
Brooke Barber. Brooke will be taking a gap year.
Carson Barker. Carson will be attending Genesee Community College for sports management.
Claire Barker. Claire will be taking a gap year before going to post-secondary.
Alan Barrett. Alan will be attending Georgian College for computer programming to pursue a career in tech security.
Trent Bass. Trent will be attending Georgian for health and fitness promotion.
Trent is also the recipient of a Helen and John Ray bursary, also being presented by Mr. Bernardi to a deserving student who's attending a post-secondary program. In addition to that, Trent is receiving the Avery Andrew Memorial Scholarship from Mr. Brent Millsap. This is to a graduating student who demonstrated strong qualities of leadership, citizenship, and active participant in extracurricular activities.
Avery Bazinet. Avery will be attending Nipissing University for Criminal Justice Studies.
Crystal Beatty. Crystal will be attending Georgian College to complete her bachelor's in nursing.
Noah Beatty. Noah will be farming.
Kate Bozart. Kate will be attending Guelph University to study biology and biomedical physics.
Liadin Bennett. Liadin will be attending Lakehead University to study criminology.
Brody Bergerman. Brody will begin his apprenticeship in carpentry.
Avery Bernardi. Avery will be attending Laurier University and the University of Sussex for political science and law.
Avery is also the recipient of the Alliston Firefighters Memorial Scholarship. This will be presented by Mr. Bill Mercer. This scholarship is for a graduating student who combines scholarship, good citizenship, and excellent attitude.
Ryan Bernardi. Ryan will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University for a Bachelor of Kinesiology.
Ryan is also the recipient of the Ontario Principals Council Award to a dedicated outstanding student nominated by the administration of the school. This will be presented by Mr. Brent Millsap. Mr. Millsap will also present him with the Stevenson Memorial Hospital Medical Staff Award, an award of merit for outstanding contribution to the school.
Michael Bickford. Michael will be attending Windsor University for concurrent education in drama.
Caleb Botting. Caleb will be attending Sheridan for Art Fundamentals.
Aaron Bowman. Aaron will be attending the University of Windsor for concurrent education and French.
Aaron is also the recipient of the Stephen Collins Memorial Award, presented by Ms. Colleen Englehart of our English department for the highest mark in grade 12 university English. Aaron's also the recipient of several language awards being presented by Ms. Gwen Evans of our languages department. Aaron will receive the Gilmore and Gilmore Award for the highest mark in grade 12 University French. She will also receive the Kenneth Inkster Scholarship for Languages, the highest mark in two grade 12 University language courses, one of which is French. And finally, she will receive the Mary McBride Latin Award for the excellence in grade 12 University Latin with participation in Curtamin and Classics Conference.
Parker Bowman. Parker will be taking a year off in writing music.
Magnus Boyer. Magnus will be attending the University of Guelph Humber for media studies.
Magnus is also the recipient of a Helen and John Ray bursary being presented by Ms. Kim Meadows of our tech department for the highest mark in grade 12 communications technology radio video.
Naomi Boyer Dick. Naomi will be attending Georgian College, taking the Developmental Service Worker Program.
Ben Brayford. Ben will be attending St. Lawrence for Business.
Hannah Brayford. Hannah will be attending Huron College at the University of Western Ontario, studying Management and Organizational Studies.
Carson Breeden. Carson will be attending Sheridan College.
Jake Brennan. Jake will be attending Laurentian University for Sports Psychology and Concurrent Education.
Grayson Brooks. Grayson will be attending Georgian College.
Alex Brown. Alex will be attending Georgian College to study Business Administration.
Austin Brown. Austin will be attending Sheridan College to pursue a career in acting.
Austin is also receiving the Sun Life Financial Award, which will be presented by Vice Principal Marcel Wolf, for the third highest overall average in a Grade 12 college destination. And Austin is also receiving the Gavin Merringer Memorial Award, presented by Kathleen Merringer, presented to a deserving student who has demonstrated a passion for and involvement in drama.
Avery Brown. Avery will be attending Ryerson University for a Bachelor in Fashion Communication.
Justin Brown. Justin will be attending Commercial Diving School in British Columbia.
Michael Brown. Michael will be attending Sheridan College for Performing Arts Preparation.
Michael is also the recipient of the Wilma G. Clayton Memorial Bursary, sponsored by the Seven Star Masonic Lodge, presented by Paul Wales. This is for the graduate who studied at the college level, who demonstrated character, ability, and promise.
Claudia Brown. Claudia will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University for a Bachelor of Social Work.
Daniel Buglio. Daniel will be taking a year off of school.
Daniel is also receiving the Baxter Corporation Award. This will be presented by our Vice Principal, Allison Trinovine, for the highest overall average, Grade 12 workplace, and going on to post-secondary education.
Grace Bruchette. Grace will be attending the University of Ottawa program in sociology.
Logan Burgess. Logan will be attending Algonquin College to study business marketing.
Braden Casey. Braden will be taking a year off to travel and explore the world.
Nikki Carr. Nikki will be attending Fleming College for Police Foundations.
Miranda Carter. Miranda will be working as a counselor at a summer camp and then taking next year to work and eventually study French.
Natalia Cassiello. Natalia will be attending Davenport University, Michigan for legal studies under a soccer scholarship.
Rebecca Catrimboni will be attending the University of British Columbia, the psychology program.
Abby Sednarski. Abby will be attending Georgian College for Police Foundations.
Tyler Charbonneau. Tyler will be attending Humber College for General Arts and Science Diploma.
Tyler is also the recipient of the Landscape Ontario George and Lakeland Chapter Award, presented by our Jeff Neely from our Science Department, for the highest mark in Grade 12 Workplace Landscaping, Construction, and Maintenance.
Kira Cheeseman. Kira will be attending Trent University for a Bachelor of Arts as a science student.
Andrew Church. Andrew will be attending the University of Waterloo to study optometry.
Brianna Clark. Brianna will be attending Nipissing University for a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Concurrent Education.
Brianna will also be receiving the Helen and John Ray Bursary, presented by Allison Chernobyl, to a deserving student who is attending a post-secondary program.
Emily Clark. Emily will be attending Carleton University for Commerce with a concentration in Finance.
Kirsten Clark. Kirsten will be attending McMaster University for Business Studies.
Kirsten is also receiving the Jack Hackett Memorial Award, to be presented by Claudia Pop from our Business Department, to a grade 12 student going on to post-secondary education in Business Studies.
Nick Coleman. Nick will be starting an electrical apprenticeship.
Melissa Collings. Melissa will be taking a year off to work.
Andrew Caldwell. Andrew is going to work to extend his knowledge of the trades and further his education in different engineering styles.
Matthias Cook. Matthias will be working at SNC Electrics.
Elizabeth Cooper. Elizabeth will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University for Linguistics and French Language Studies.
Elizabeth is also receiving the Stephen Collins Memorial Award, presented by Colleen Engelhart, for the highest mark in grade 12 University English. And she's also receiving the Cultural Award, presented by Lisa Bell from our Arts Department, for outstanding work in the arts. And Elizabeth will also receiving the Banting Memorial Music MVP Award, presented by Matt Healy from our Music Department, to the graduating student who has demonstrated leadership, strength of character, and has made an exemplary contribution to the musical life at Banting, voted by fellow musicians.
Dana Corum. Dana will be attending Seneca College for Pre-Health Sciences.
Rebecca Kors. Rebecca is planning on being a journalist in an office and not driving her uncle and aunt up the wall.
Kieran Crawford. Kieran will be playing Junior A hockey next year in North Bay for the Powassan Voodoos in North Bay Battalion.
David Crombie will be working on the farm.
Alessandra Kermi. Alessandra will be attending York University and majoring in criminology to pursue the career as a lawyer.
Alessandra is also receiving the Former Staff Member Award, Ruth Smith and Norma Moore Memorial Award, presented by Tammy Storms from our Social Science Department, the highest mark in Grade 12 University College Human Development throughout the lifespan.
Roman Zagor. Roman will be attending Laurier University for Business Administration.
Melissa D'Amico. Melissa will be attending the University of Toronto to study political science.
Kristen Daly. Kristen will be attending Georgian College for Architectural Technology.
Kristen is also receiving the Wilmot G. Clayton Memorial Bursary, sponsored by the Seven Star Masonic Lodge, presented by Paul Wales, for a graduate who studied at the college level and demonstrated character, ability, and promise.
Ben Danby. Ben will be attending McMaster University for Mathematics and Statistics.
Tanner Darlington. Tanner will be attending St. Lawrence College to become an electrical engineering technician.
Tanner is also receiving the Honda of Canada Manufacturing Award, presented by Troy Lambert from Honda, for a student who has distinguished himself both in class and through active involvement in school or community and proceeding to post-secondary in engineering.
Claire Dasig. Claire will be attending Laurentian University for concurrent education with sports psychology.
Claire is also receiving the Beta Sigma Phi Betty Lawson Memorial Award, presented by Mr. Verdi, to an excellent behind-the-scenes worker.
Joshua Davidson. Josh will be attending Windsor University for concurrent education in drama.
Danielle Daw. Danielle will be taking a year to discover new beginnings and opportunities around the world.
Sam De Bruin. Sam will be attending Trent University to study nursing.
Abigail DeJong. Abigail will be attending Nipissing University for registered nursing.
Faith DeVries. Faith will be attending Western University for Health Sciences.
Damiana DeFreitas. Damiana will be attending Niagara College for Horticultural Technician Program.
Damiana was receiving the Alliance AgriTurf Agricultural Award presented by Therese Law from our Science Department to a student continuing their education in agriculture or a related field. And he's also receiving the CW Leach Farms Award in memory of David Leach, presented by our Community Policing Officer, Officer Daniels, to a top student pursuing agricultural type studies.
Brandon Del Greco. Brandon will be attending Hummer College for Architectural Technology.
Alexandra DePiro. Alexandra will be attending George Brown for Construction Engineering.
And after this, we're just going to have a quick change of presenters. Mr. Turnby is going to present the next set of awards.
Dilpreet Duga. Dilpreet will be attending the University of Ottawa, studying for a joint honors in public administration and political science.
Dilpreet will be receiving the Tetra Ninja Productions Award, presented by Dana Wright. Hold on, Mr. Chip. Thank you. Presented to the highest mark in grade 12, University of Canadian World Politics. And now, Miss Ritchie, you can come on up. She'll be presenting the Helen John Ray Bursary for the highest mark in grade 12 University College and Change in Society, as well as the Community Banting Community Award for the highest mark in 12 UC Equity and Social Justice. Miss Ritchie, that's you again, dear.
Connor Dixon. Connor will be attending Brock University for a BBA in Entrepreneurship.
Reagan Dobis. Reagan will be attending York University for Health Science and Kinesiology.
Kendra Douglas. Kendra will be taking a gap year to make some money.
Mackenzie Drummond. Mackenzie will be attending University of Western Ontario for Health Science.
Matthew Duff. Matthew will be getting an apprenticeship somewhere in mechanics.
Aaron Dunn. Aaron will be attending Fanshawe College studying interactive media and design.
Aaron is also the recipient of the Parliament Auto Body Award presented by Kim Meadows of our Tech Department for the highest mark in grade 12 Communications Technology Photography.
Alan Dunster. Alan will be attending George Brown College for gaming programming.
Alan is also receiving the Simcoe County OSSTF Award, presented by Mr. Rob Howitson, for the second highest overall average grade 12 college destination. In addition to that, he is receiving a Helen and John Ray Bursary for the highest mark in grade 12 college apprenticeship math, presented by Mr. Doug Bushby of our math department.
Daniel Jura. Daniel will be attending the University of Waterloo Environmental Studies and Business Program.
Johnny Earle. Johnny will be attending the University of Western Ontario to study Health Sciences.
Nathan Ecker. Nathan will be taking a year off.
Caleb Eichler. Caleb will be attending Georgian College to study computer programming.
Caleb is also the recipient of the Banting Community Award, presented by Mr. Doug Henderson, for the highest mark in grade 12 workplace food and healthy living.
Jordan Elliott. Jordan will be attending Georgian College for accounting.
Gavin Emmett. Gavin will be joining the military to become a military mechanic.
Jackson Enright. Jackson will be attending the University of Waterloo for computer engineering.
Jackson is also the recipient of the Royal Canadian Branch 329 Tottenham Tim Wilson Memorial Scholarship Award, and I'd like to invite Deborah Hill to present this award to the, Kale Cohen, to present this award for the highest mark in graduating student with the highest mark on 6 university credits from the Tottenham area. In addition to that, Jackson is receiving 2 awards from Mr. Doug Bushby from our math department, both sponsored by the Stevenson Memorial Hospital medical staff, for the highest mark in grade 12 university calculus and vectors, and the highest mark in grade 12 university advanced functions.
Abby Ewing. Abby will be taking a gap year, then will be applying to Ryerson for interior design.
Megan Ewing. Megan will be attending the University of Toronto.
Olivia Fandridge. Olivia will be taking a year off to work at an orphanage in Brazil for 2 months.
Megan is also receiving the Mackenzie Beattie Memorial Award, being presented by Ms. Arwin Tasinga from our science department for the highest mark in grade 12 college chemistry.
Mia Fielding. Mia will be attending the University of Western Ontario in the School for Advanced Studies in Arts and Humanities and Art History.
Mia is also receiving the Artist at Gibson Award for the highest mark in grade 12 University College Visual Arts, presented by Ms. Lisa Bell of our Arts Department. Ms. Engelhart will be presenting you with the Banting Community Award for the highest mark grade 12 University Writer's Craft. And Ms. Chornabai will be presenting you with the Stevenson Memorial Hospital Medical Staff Award, an award of merit for outstanding contribution to the school.
Courtney Fillier. Courtney will be attending Fanshawe College for interior decorating.
Kobe Fisher. Kobe will be attending the University of Ottawa with a Bachelor of Fine Arts.
Kobe is also receiving a William and Kim Ray Arts Bursary presented by Ms. Madeline Ray to a deserving student who is studying fine arts in a post-secondary education.
Abby Forrester. Abby will be attending Nipissing University for Criminal Justice.
Kaylee Bowers. Kaylee will be taking a year off to work.
Megan Forrester. Megan will be attending Seneca for Early Childhood Education.
Olivia Fox. Olivia will be attending Conestoga College for Occupational Therapy and Physiotherapy Assistant.
Catherine Franklin. Catherine will be taking a year off to find her own interests.
Julia Franks. Julia will be attending Humber for Fashion, Arts, and Business.
Gage Braska. Gage will be working with his grandpa restoring old cars.
Aaron Fraser. Aaron will be attending the University of Waterloo for Civil Engineering.
Kylie Freeborn. Kylie will be attending Humber for Community and Justice Services.
Braden Gabrick. Braden will be taking a year off to work and then plans to attend Police Foundation's College at Georgian and Orillia in 2020.
Logan Gammon. Logan will be studying funeral directing services at Humber College.
Sasha Garforth. Sasha will be attending Lakehead University for concurrent education.
Andrea Gator. Andrea will be attending York University for a concurrent education in history program.
Jenny G. Jenny will be attending Fleming College for firefighting.
Earlier this month, Jenny was also recognized as our Female Athlete of the Year at our Athletic Awards banquet.
Courtney Gobi. Courtney will be attending Trent University to study forensic biology.
Aaron Gibb. Aaron will be attending Laurentian University for concurrent education as a history major.
Navjeet Gill. Navjeet will be making a clothing brand, Nava, 2 movies, 2 albums.
Andrew Giovanetti. Andrew will be going to Fanshawe to study finance.
Amanda Godfrey. Amanda will be taking a year off working and grinding for that bank.
Ben Gooch. Ben will be working, attending McMaster University for engineering.
Toby Goff. Toby will be working at finding a trade in carpentry.
Toby is also the recipient of the Zares Market Award. I'd like to ask Ms. Pauline Engelhardt to come to the stage to present it, the highest mark in grade 12 workplace English.
Christina Green. Christina will be taking a gap year to travel.
Lucas Haas. Lucas will be attending Algonquin College for carpentry and joinery.
Nathaniel Hartley. Nathaniel will be attending Trent University studying animal biology.
Nathaniel is also receiving the Boyne Veterinary Clinic Award, presented by Teresa Wallant, for the highest mark in Grade 12 University College Livestock Production. And Nathaniel is also this year the Athlete of the Year.
Serenity Harvey Dick. Serenity will be attending King's University College at Western University for Disability Studies.
Christopher Heggie. Christopher will be taking a year off to decide.
Christopher is also the recipient of the highest mark in 12 Workplace Mathematics and Anti-Community Award, presented by Doug Bushby.
Kyle Heikala. Kyle will be attending Fanshawe College for Construction Engineering.
Jocelyn Hilliard. Jocelyn will be working for a year and then attending Canadian Beauty College.
Jacob Hiltz. Jacob will be playing Junior A hockey in Kirkland Lake.
Ryan Hines. Ryan will be attending Queen's University to pursue studies in biochemistry.
Noah Hodder. Noah will be taking a gap year.
Erica Hoffman. Erica will be going to Ryerson University to study professional communications, to talk to and inspire as many people as she can.
Erica is also receiving the David Kent Leadership Award, presented by Damon McLaughlin from our Physical Education Department for the highest mark in Grade 12 University College Recreation and Healthy Active Living, and also receiving the Joseph Delaney Memorial Scholarship Award, presented by Misty Hughes, for the highest mark in Grade 12 College University Technology Design.
Anna Horvath. Anna will be attending the University of Ontario to study forensic psychology.
Anna is also receiving the Helen and John Ray Bursary, presented by Alberto Bernardi, to a deserving student who is attending a post-secondary program. Anna is also receiving the Boston Pizza Award, presented by Amanda Fowley and Marina Hollister, to a deserving student who has overcome significant adversity and is attending a post-secondary program.
Amy Howard. Amy will be attending University of Waterloo to study psychology.
Amy is also receiving the Banting Community Award, presented by Damon McLaughlin, for the highest mark in Grade 12 University Introductory Kinesiology.
Sam Howe. Sam will be attending Laurentian University for Concurrent Education.
Sam is also receiving the Banting Community Award for the highest mark in Grade 12 Open Health and Physical Education, presented by Damon McLaughlin.
Paige House. Paige will be attending Sheridan College for Makeup, for Media, and Creative Arts.
Larissa Hughes. Larissa will be attending Heritage College for Intercultural Studies.
Jesse Human. Jesse will be attending MTM College for Animation and Arts to be an illustrator.
Jessica is receiving two awards, both presented by Lisa Bell, the South Simcoe Pilot Club Award for the highest mark in Grade 12 Portfolio Development, and the Banting Community Award for highest mark in Grade 12 University College Advanced Ceramics.
Alexandria Hunter. Alexandra will be taking a gap year and going to university the following year.
Phibia Hunter. Phibia will be attending Humber College for Travel and Tourism Services Management.
Imabong Edom. Imabong will be attending Trinity School for Medicine and Pre-Medical Science.
Imabong Edom will be attending the Tana T School of Medicine for Pre-Med Program.
Kayla J. Paul. Kayla will be attending Seneca King's Campus for Social Service Work.
Kayla James. Kayla will be attending Guelph University for the Bachelor of Arts, Communications, and Cinema Studies.
Corbin Jarvis. Corbin will be taking a gap year to figure things out.
Vanessa Jeb. Vanessa will be taking a year off to travel.
Athavan Jason Essen. Athavan will be going to University for Computer Security and Mathematics.
Athavan is also receiving the Sydney Owens Memorial Award, presented by Brian Haas of our Science Department, for the highest mark in grade 12 computer technology.
Colin Jones. Colin will be going to Georgian College for firefighting.
Tyra Jordan. Tyra will be attending Brescia University College to study criminal justice.
Hannah Kalmans. Hannah will be moving to Switzerland.
Mika Karunami. Mika will be attending Cambrian College to become a power line technician.
Haley Keenan will be taking a year off to work and explore her options before going to college.
Kaylin Kemp. Kaylin will be attending Durham College for Biotechnology.
Rogan Kennedy. Rogan will be attending Humber College.
Tommy Kipfer. Tommy will begin his apprenticeship as a heavy machinery operator.
Haley Knowlton. Haley will be attending Seneca College Health and Fitness Promotion.
Danil Kovac. Danil will be going to Georgian for Police Foundation.
Maya Krasowski. Maya will be attending Brescia College at Western University for Criminal Justice.
Maya is also receiving the Helen and John Gray Bursary, presented by Brent Millsap, to a deserving student who is attending a post-secondary program.
Alyssa Krajewski. Alyssa will be looking for agricultural apprenticeship and starting her next stage of life.
Alyssa is the recipient of the Alliston Herald Award, presented by Pauline Engelhardt, for the highest mark in grade 12 college writer's craft. And we're going to switch presenters here. Next week, Brent Millsap.
Kongwan Kwok. Kongwan will be attending University of Waterloo for Life Sciences in Psychology.
Okay, Kongwan is receiving the Sun Life Financial Award. Don't go anywhere yet here. Sunlight Financial Award, presented by Marcel Wolf for the third highest overall average in grade 12 university. Also receiving the Stevenson Memorial Hospital Fund Bursary in memory of Mr. Lauren Whiteside, presented by Jennifer Manicom and Mary Beth Hennian, to a student with 80% average entering a health-related profession. She's also receiving the Mackenzie B. Memorial Award, presented by Arwin Tasinga from the Science Department for the highest mark in grade 12 University of Biology. And the Mackenzie B. Memorial Award for the highest mark in grade 12 University of Chemistry, presented by Steve Villard. And the Tetra Ninja Productions Award, presented by Kevin Runnels, from the Guidance Department, to a student who has demonstrated significant courage in facing personal challenges.
Taylor LaJoie. Taylor will be attending Seneca College for Criminal Analysis and Investigation.
Madison Lane. Madison will be working full-time and then going to college.
Lauren Lashy. Lauren will be attending Georgian College, York University, for a Bachelor of Science in Nursing.
Braden LaFave. Braden will be apprenticing as an auto mechanic.
Davis Leibel. Davis will be attending Centennial College for Heavy Machinery Diesel Mechanic.
Davis is also the recipient of the Terry Weatherup Memorial Scholarship being presented by Carrie Ellen Clark Weatherup to a student entering a trade that performed over and above community service hours in an outdoor capacity, has a passion for the outdoors, and exhibits great leadership and technical skills.
Matthew Lemire. Matthew will be taking a year off.
Jacob Lindsay. Jacob will be attending Ryerson University for media production and continuing his dance career in Toronto.
Amber Lonesberry. Amber will be working at a golf course and then attending George Brown College.
Ariana Lopez. Ariana will be attending the University of British Columbia for a Bachelor of Science degree in pharmacy with a minor in French.
Ariana is also the recipient of the Kenneth Inkster Scholarship for Languages being presented by Ms. Gwen Ovens for the most deserving top French student. Next, I'd like to call Mr. Larry Keogh back to the stage to present Ariana with the LP Keogh Volunteer Award to a graduating student who demonstrates exemplary voluntary service throughout high school and has benefited our local community.
Alyssa Lopez. Alyssa will be attending the University of Ottawa for Honors in International Development and Globalization Co-op Program.
Sydney Lovett. Sydney will be working to pay for traveling and avoiding student debt for one more year.
Elizabeth Luckman. Elizabeth will be attending Seneca College for Honors Bachelor of Aviation Technology.
Cooper McAdams. Cooper will be attending Ontario Tech University for Mechanical Engineering.
Mackenzie McFarlane. Mackenzie will be taking a gap year and then going to Fanshawe College for Nursing.
Faith McIntyre. Faith will be taking a gap year.
Patrick McKinley. Patrick will be attending Aurelia Georgian for Police Foundations.
Jack McKinnon. Jack will be attending Georgian College for Civil Engineering.
Daniel McLeod. Daniel will be attending Sioux College for Aviation Flight Program.
Abby McTaggart. Abby will be attending Queen's University to study in the engineering program.
Abby is also the recipient of the Honda Canada Manufacturing Award, being presented by Mr. Troy Lambert of Honda, for a student who distinguished herself both in class and through active involvement in school and a community, who will be proceeding on to post-secondary education in an engineering-related field.
Isha Mahmood. Isha will be attending the University of British Columbia to study international relations.
Corey Main. Corey will be taking a year off.
Jacob Major. Jacob will be attending the University of Ottawa for an undergraduate degree in biochemistry.
Ryan Malatesta. Ryan will be taking a gap year to work.
Katie Mullaney. Katie will be taking a year off to explore her options and expand her knowledge.
Sierra Mangialardi. Sierra will be working at Tim's and maybe attending art school.
Oldrick Václav Mateka. Oldrick will play hockey for the NCDC Utica Comets.
Kyle McAddy. Kyle will be starting his own CNC business.
Kip McKeag. Kip will be going to Georgia College for HVAC.
Duncan McDonald. Duncan will be attending Georgian College for Fitness and Health Promotion.
Hannah McGregor. Hannah will be attending Queen's University for Life Sciences.
Connor McElwain. Connor will be attending Conestoga College for Architecture and Construction Engineering.
Connor is also the recipient of the Mackenzie Beattie Memorial Award, being presented by Mr. Mike Wright for the highest mark in grade 12 college physics. And where Mike is not there, I will stand in.
Oh, Keith.
Austin McKibben. Austin will be working on the farm and playing hockey.
Kiara McLean. Kiara will be attending Niagara College for Pre-Health Sciences.
Dexter McMillan. Dexter will be attending a degree in computer science.
Blake Melling. Blake will be attending Seneca College for Fitness and Health Promotions.
Blake is also the recipient of the Guac Mexi Grill Award, being presented by Ms. Alana Cowell of our Hospitality Department, highest mark in grade 12 workplace hospitality and tourism.
Cameron Mercer. Cameron will be attending Georgian College to study computer technology in pursuit of becoming a technological magician.
Cameron is also the recipient of a Lions Club Award being presented by Ms. Jennifer McCaig to a deserving student going on to college.
Cassidy Metcalf. Cassidy will be attending Seneca College for Fitness and Health Promotion.
Cassidy is also the recipient of a Landmark Bus Lines Award being presented by Ms. Allison Chornabai for a student achieving the highest overall average in grade 12 college destination. In addition to that, Cassidy is receiving a Helen and John Ray Bursary being presented by Mr. Damon McLaughlin of our Phys Ed Department for the highest mark in grade 12 open personal and fitness activities.
Bailey Melko. Bailey will be attending Humber College for early childhood education.
Devin Miller. Devin will be attending Carleton University for political science.
Will Miller. Will will be attending Laurier for psychology.
Mark Mitchell. Mark will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University to study business and financial math.
Mark is also the recipient of two awards being presented by Ms. Claudia Papa of our business department. The first, the Alliston District Chamber of Commerce Award to a student who shows dedication, enthusiasm, professionalism, and a commitment to business studies. And the second, the Howard Noble Scholarship to a graduating student pursuing business studies in a post-secondary institution.
Bruce Middlestadt. Bruce will be attending Mohawk for Police Foundations.
Jonathan Mohabir. Jonathan will be attending Humber College for Business Management.
Evan Moon. Evan will be attending Brock University for Sports Management.
Aaron Morrison. Aaron will be attending Cambrian College for Heavy Equipment Mechanics.
Aaron is also the recipient of the Banting Community Award being presented by Ms. Tammy Storms for the highest mark in grade 12 University College the World of Fashion. Mr. Rick Parliament is here to present the Parliament Auto Body Award for the highest achievement in grade 12 college transportation auto body. Mr. Scott Fuller of our tech department is here to present her with the Williamson Automotive Award for the highest achievement in grade 12 college transportation auto mechanics, who intends to pursue a career in automotive tech. And Kathleen Merringer is here to present the Zach Merringer Memorial Award to a deserving student who has shown a passion for and intends to pursue a career in automotive technology.
Max Morrow. Max will be attending Fleming College and taking the electrical technician's course and then going to attend an electrical apprenticeship.
Jerry Morton. Jerry will be attending Humber College for electronics engineering.
Mr. Millsap will also be presenting Jerry with the Helen and John Ray Bursary to a deserving student who's attending a post-secondary program.
John Carlos Mota. John Carlos will be attending Centennial College for Heavy Equipment.
James Moses. James will be attending Georgian College for Mechanical Engineering.
Olivia will be studying early childhood education at Georgia. Austin will be attending Thomas Miller College to become a welding inspector.
Austin Custer. Austin will join the Canadian military. Ready to a graduating student involved in student success program who is encouraged perseverance and significant personal and academic growth.
Sam Holder. Sam Holder is going to be Coffee University for Business and Making.
Arlene Rye. Arlene will be attending Ryerson University for an undeclared arts.
Angelina Rendis. Angelina will be attending York University for Bachelor of Arts in Education in third program.
Rebecca Ramna. Rebecca will be attending Carleton University to obtain a Bachelor of Arts Honors degree in Forensic Psychology.
Mary Ray. Mary will be attending Seneca College for 911 services and communications.
Mary is also a recipient of the A.K.A. Memorial Scholarship presented by Mr. Brandon. This goes to graduating students who demonstrate strong qualities, leadership, citizenship, and active participants in extracurricular activities.
Thomas Runger. Thomas will be exploring the world.
Brendan Reed. Brendan will be attending Police Fire Academy for pre-service firefighting.
Chelsea Green. Chelsea will be attending Trent University for Forensic Science.
Hunter Reed. Hunter Reed did an apprenticeship with Lewis Lowers as a diesel mechanic.
Veronica Reitz. Veronica will be attending the University of Calgary for concurrent education.
Nathan Ryder. Nathan will be attending York University for biotechnology.
Andrew Robinson. Andrew will be working next year.
Isaiah Rodriguez. Isaiah will be taking a year off.
Isabella Romero. Isabella will be attending Brock University for psychology.
Olivia Rose. Olivia will be attending University of Ottawa for International Studies and Modern Languages in French and Russian.
Olivia is also the recipient of our Karen Mulder Award, being presented by Ms. Anne Smith, for graduating students who combine scholarship, good citizenship, and excellent attitude.
Camille Roylands. Camille will be taking a gap year to travel across Canada.
Madison Russell. Madison will be taking a year off to travel to Australia and going to college for hair sound and makeup.
Bennett Run. Bennett will be attending Georgia to learn poetry and get a job making coffee.
Alex Sands. Alex will be attending Dallas University for Commerce.
Rafael Santos. Rafael will be attending Harvard College to study photography.
Mary Ellen Savoy. Mary Ellen will be going to Lakehead for geoarchaeology.
Kyle Slaughter. Kyle will be working with seniors at the Simcoe Manor.
Alex Shannon. Alex will be going to Georgia College Business.
Victoria Shearer. Victoria will be attending the University of Ottawa for a Bachelor of Arts in Psychology.
Logan Shepard. Logan will be working at Honda.
Tyson Silva. Tyson will be going to Brazil to play soccer.
Tyson Slade. Tyson will be working at an English lecturer as an apprentice.
Amanda Soley. Amanda will be attending Durham College to study special event management.
Samantha Zip. Samantha will be attending Centennial College to lead the industry arts and performing.
Dean Silverman. Dayton will be attending Hunter College for sports management.
This award will also be presented to Dayton with the Helen and John Reed Bursary to a deserving student who is attending post-secondary program. And Scotty Pop will be presented to Dayton with the Jack Hackett Memorial Award to a grade 12 student going on to post-secondary education and business studies.
Sarah Summer. Sarah will be attending Marietta College for practical nursing.
Emma Smith. Emma will be attending Rock University for concurrent education.
Sydney Spellman. Sydney will be doing concurrent education at Queen's University.
Okay, and Sydney's name for this year. She's won a number of awards. The first one is the Peter B. Stolle Barrister and Solicitor's Award, presented by Mr. Rob House in the panel of the Fifth Tournament for the student year of the High Center from the Virtual University of Canadian International Law. The second is also in the panel of studies, Mr. Nathan Scott McLaren, the highest mark in grade 12 University Geography World Issues. This is for the Sherman McKinnon Moral Award. Mr. Bernardi will be presenting John Phillips Darby Memorial Award to the deserving superintendent of Queen's University. He's also receiving the Dr. Kelly HMP Youth Award from Jennifer Armstrong. This is to a graduating student going on post-secondary studies who's demonstrated leadership at school and in the community. He's also receiving the Rotary Club of Allison Paul Harris High School Scholarship from Mr. Bill Ray, a student going on to post-secondary education who demonstrated leadership in the community. And she's also receiving the Royal Canadian Legion Grant 329 Tottenham Hill Palmer Memorial Citizenship Award from Dora Dickmore to a graduating student from the Tottenham area for outstanding citizenship and service. And lastly, she's receiving the Cheryl J. Walsh Foundation Award from Ms. Debbie Barber for deserving student going on to post-secondary studies.
Jordana Staley. Jordana will be attending Centennial College Support Support Service Program.
Jordana is also receiving a Helen and John Ray Bursary from Mr. Wolf, and this is a deserving student from Centennial Post Secondary Program.
Ainsley Stewart. Ainsley will be attending the University of Waterloo for Life Sciences.
Ashley Sinopoli. Ashley will be attending the Baccalaureate for Criminology.
Laura Cernelli. Laura will be taking a gap year to volunteer at a school.
Jody Sturgeon. Jody will be attending the University of Waterloo for Social Development Studies.
Mateo Summers. Mateo will be attending Boston College for Rolling Carnegie.
Brooklyn Sarah. Brooklyn will be attending the University of Law for Bachelor of Science.
Michael Swan. Michael will be attending the University of Florida and Florida.
Dalton Page. Dalton will begin his apprenticeship as electrician.
Jessica Gutierrez. Jessica will be attending Lawrence University for preparing to become a special education teacher. Jessica will also receive the Charlotte Parents Memorial Award presented by Randy Bailey. This is to a champion of inclusion through innovative and compassionate deeds benefited and enhanced the well-being of high school students.
Cheyenne Taylor. Cheyenne will be attending Connor College to study child and youth care.
Elizabeth Heather. Elizabeth will be attending Connor Southern College for pre-health sciences.
Elizabeth Tessier. Elizabeth will be attending, Elizabeth will be studying life science and biotechnology at Lincoln University.
Elizabeth is receiving the Banting Community Award, presented by the Donna Poop, for the highest mark in Great Falls University in the trip to Pentecost. Drake Thompson. Drake will be attending Carleton University for engineering.
Jordan Coleman. Jordan will be attending Algonquin College for business marketing.
Michael Todd. Michael will be taking a year off.
Julia Poles. Julia will be taking a gap year to work, then attending college for diagnostic medical sonography.
Julia is also receiving a yearbook award, presented by Holly Engelhardt, for the highest mark in grade 12 college English. She's also receiving a Banting Community Award, for the highest mark in grade 12 college nutrition, from Beth Henderson. Adelaide Truman. Adelaide will be attending the University of British Columbia for Bachelor of Science in Global Resource Systems. Mitchell will also be presenting with the Bachelor Corporation Award, the second highest overall average to British Columbia University. And he's also receiving the Helen and John Ray Bursary, presented by Julie Valentine, the highest mark in British Columbia University World History. And finally, she's also being awarded the Allison District Sportsman Club Award, presented by Bob Major, who is pursuing studies in environmental, wildlife, natural resources, conservation, forestry, agriculture, or natural resource law enforcement.
Taylor Trump. Taylor will be attending the University of Waterloo for honors health studies.
Kaya Tudor. Kaya will be attending Guelph University for Media Studies.
Michaela Valentini. Michaela will be attending Nipissing University for Bachelor of Business Administration with Concurrent Education.
Laurel Wheeling, Bunnyman. Will be attending the Rutgers University for Bachelor of Science work at the UCAP Communication Service Systems.
Allison Newendall. Allison will be attending Santa College for Health and Fitness Promotion.
Lindsay Van Mute. Lindsay will be attending the University of Ottawa for Modern Languages and Cultures.
Nicole Van Houten. Nicole will be attending the University of Guelph for Biology and Sociology.
And Nicole is receiving the Banting Community Award, presented by the Dark Hoop, for the highest mark in grade 12 university fans in Canada. Daryl Bird. Daryl will be attending Ottawa University for Criminology and French Immersion. And Daryl will be receiving the Kathy and Jane Smith Award, presented by Jane Greece, to an extended French student continuing French studies at a university. And he is also receiving the Royal Page Charter
Relay Award, presented by Pat McKay and Amanda Mortimer, to a deserving student who demonstrates probity, citizenship, academic success, and is attending a post-secondary program.
Nina Reno. Nina will be attending Algonquin College for Justice Studies.
Nina is also receiving the Banting Memorial Music MVP Award, presented by Matt Healy. The graduating student demonstrates leadership, strength of character, and has made an exemplary contribution to the musical life of Banting. Nina is also receiving the Royal Canadian Arts and Art Realty Award, presented by Pat McKay and Amanda Mortimer. To a deserving student who demonstrates probity, citizenship, academic success, and is attending a post-secondary program. Katie Walden. Katie will be attending Jefferson University for nursing.
Roy Wales. Roy will be attending Ontario Tech University for computer programming.
Roy is also receiving the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 508 Everett Award, presented by Mr. Brown, to the highest overall average of a graduating student from Agile Tossa Ratio. Haley Wallace. Haley will be taking a year off to work full time.
Matt Walsh. Matt will be working in the construction trade.
Matt is also receiving the GoWell Award presented by Brent Shaw, presented by Mr. Hughes, to the highest mark in grade 12 college construction tech. Maurizio Walters.
Alexis Warburton. Alexis will be attending Georgia College for Pre-Health Sciences.
Alexis is also receiving the Canadian Tire Adelson Award, presented by Aurora Marty, to a deserving graduate who is going to post-secondary studies. Danielle Wardrobe. Danielle will be working at Imagine Cinema's Poppy Popcorn and then attending school for social work or psychology. Danielle is also receiving the Banting Community Award presented by Bob Anderson to the highest mark in grade 12 personal life management.
Palmer Wells. Palmer will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University for Film Studies.
And Palmer is also receiving the Banting Community Award, presented by Lauren Olson for the highest mark in grade 12 drama. And Father Pocket presents the Stephen Lennon Memorial Award for the highest mark in grade 12 business leadership. And Mr. Bernardi will present the Tank Guard Community Volunteer Award for the certificate for the most community service hours.
Studies.
Ty Wilner. Ty will be attending Sheridan College to become a theatrical makeup artist.
Kelsey Wright. Kelsey will be attending Laurentian University to study concurrent education, majoring in Indigenous Studies.
Killian Wright. Killian will be traveling.
And that, folks, those are our guests.
Okay, now the highlight for you guys, and probably the speaker you're most looking forward to. I have the pleasure of introducing a student who was elected by you folks to represent and speak for them. It's a huge honor, and I'd like to welcome to the stage our valedictorian in 2019, Mr. Conquest.
How's everybody doing tonight? My name is Paul Wells, and it is my absolute pleasure to be here at valedictorian and to represent this wonderful graduating class. I am very thankful to my peers for putting their trust into me, and I'm confident in my ability to cap off four not so long years of such a big era in our lives. And as much as some of you want to leave Banting and figure out all about it, I want to remind you that there's a lot of good in the high school experience, even if that means something different to everybody. The first draft of this speech was 13 minutes long. But I stretched those in charge too much just to disrespect them, so I was trying to stick to my point. I was doing 4 minutes for about 4 years. I'm going to do it, and I'm going to do it fast, so please bear with me. Webster's Dictionary defines... No, I'm kidding, I'm not using that line, so good shit. Actually, I am. Webster's Dictionary defines nostalgia as a sentimental longing or wistful affection for the past, typically for a period or place with happy personal associations. A wistful affection for the past. I think we all get a real nostalgic feeling whenever things come to an end. It's important to note, I assume you're all taking notes, that in a couple months, high school will be considered the good old days, you know, which is there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you actually left them. And I think if you let any hard feelings towards high school and the people there consume you, then you miss out on recognizing all the good that happened. Little moments, even. For me, some of the best things in my life happened in these past 4 years. While some of the worst have, the good always outweighs the bad. And if you can't say the same thing, I'm here to tell you you can. Here's why. A year from now, 10 years, 20. When you look back on your time in high school, not only will you have forgotten the bad, but it will no longer have an impact on your life whatsoever. And if it does, it's because it made you the man and woman you are today. We're here because of the good and the bad. That's important to note. Anyways. Thunderstruck, AC/DC. That's how high school began. I was leaning into the long French class, and Thunderstruck was blasting through the speakers. I don't know whose idea that was, because it was supposed to tighten up or something, it failed, which increased my anxiety. I was minding my own business.
Thunderstruck!
If they had played something like Don't Stop Believing or Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, that would have been much more calming. But along with that rocky start, as a graduating class, we all face different challenges, different adversaries, different things that set us down. Think we would fail, but what we all have in common is that we're sitting here in this room tonight. That's resiliency. I admire each and every one of you for it. Some of you may think high school will be, but look at where you're sitting, the cap you're wearing. If that's not success, then I don't know what it is. In September, my journey to the film industry begins. and whether you're going to university, college, an apprenticeship, taking a gap year to travel, whatever. We're all just looking for success in our own craft. And as cliche as it sounds, we can't give up on what we want. You see, the truth is anything is possible. You just have to believe in yourself. Whatever you want to do in your future, someone has to do it. Why not you? That's the mindset I have, and so should you. If you got a dream, you got to protect it. If you want something, go get it. Make it a reality, whatever it takes. I mean, we're talking about dreams. I want to make films. My peak is what? Hollywood? What about all of you? Doctors, lawyers, soccer players, hockey players, laborers, musicians, teachers, artists. Pretty competitive, it's going to take everything we got. But there must be, and always will be, someone who has to act upon an artistic vision. Is crucial that all of you have that same mentality. We have to do these things not because they are easy, but because they are hard, because they challenge us to do new, fun, exciting things. And as I close, I want to leave you this graduating class with a quote. Here it is. Your future hasn't been written yet. No one has. Your future is whatever you make it. So make it a good one. That was, of course, said by Dr. Emmett Brown in Back to the Future, Part 3. Ladies and graduates, our future is whatever we want it to be. The next few years is when we will determine just what that is. Whatever it is you want to do in life, it lies in your hands, and your hands only. And maybe it's not my place to say this, but I want to encourage you all to do what makes you happy. So my friends, a sentimental longing, a wistful affection for the past, a period or place of happy, personal, associations. That's what high school means to me. Remember the good times. Remember those little moments. Remember your friends. Get their cell phone number. Remember the teachers. Remember spring days when they were packed with you. Remember the parties. Remember the movie nights. Remember the good times. Because it's not until you leave do you realize it's over. I love you all very much. Please, keep in touch.
Palmer, you need to stay. Okay. And now I have the pleasure of reintroducing Aisha Mahmood, our student council president, to present Palmer with a plaque. Okay, we've done it. We've reached the end of our program. I have one small thing to ask before we dismiss you all, and that is please recycle your water bottles. We provide water for you, but it will take us forever to go through the green and pick them up. Again, graduates, congratulations. What an awesome accomplishment. Big round of applause for our grads of 2019.